It's actually a bobo style.
You dance at clubs and whatnot?
I mean, yeah.
You should move it to the heat.
You push it, Jamal, with your durag? Not durag. Fuck.
Wow.
Durag. Wow.
Do you have, you know?
Those subconscious white people, I'm always like, do you welcome the, like, race conversation?
Careful.
Jack walks away.
Whatever you want, anyway. Durag. Jack is walking by and he says, oh, Jamal, can you use your durag to lift the pot? And immediately I, like, stand up and kind of look at him.
I made a joke. That sucked. I immediately knew that I had said something wrong, and I was very embarrassed to have said it. Like, I just was, like, thinking about it, like, makes me sweaty, and I just, like, I felt really bad because I felt like I compromised. I felt like Jamal views me in this mature way, and I feel like I just took steps backward. I want you to know, like, I'm embarrassed I did that to you.
Hopefully we can move forward from here.
I agree.
It'll take me a little bit of time, so I hope you can respect that, but
absolutely.
Good. It's a little complicated about why this is insulting. And I can understand why someone might think, what's the big deal? Don't black men wear durags? The problem with it is the image that probably a lot of white America has about black men is the thug, the deadbeat father, right? The leech on social services, which is often, unfortunately, people wearing durags, tattoos, wife beaters, right? So this whole caricature is so ingrained in our culture and so comfortable for mainstream white America to digest about the black male body that for a sweet, well-intentioned boy like Jack, it flows off the tongue.
You got pillars of identity, right? So race, gender, you have sexual orientation, socioeconomic status, you have religion. Interesting to recognize it and see it that way, though.
Very.
Yeah. White straight men have a really long way to go when it comes to, like, self-awareness about their privilege in this world.
Yeah, and I think that is why I feel so poorly about what I did, but also what I'm taking with me, what you're saying, is that me being more aware of that spectrum you just laid out, because I fall on the top step.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of places where I can be more of an activist in those regards.
Yeah. I think that's exactly right. Now, reach a little further, where do you think you can possibly understand what it's like to be on the bottom?
On the bottom.
Jamal has a way of helping me understand that privileges do exist. Like, you know, I don't think of myself as the most privileged person, but when the fact of the matter is, I am very privileged, like I am. And it was really cool to share a very human moment with my strongest ally, because it brought us together more as friends, even though I made this very stupid comment.
Thank you for allowing me to apologize.
Yeah, no, thank you for doing so. It means a lot. And it's helpful for me to be able to talk that way out here, because it's hard to know when it's safe to come on strong with this kind of thing, you know?
No, I mean, I want you to.
Yeah.
Especially with me, like, yeah. You're comfortable doing that with me.
Yeah, and because it can be divisive, and we're playing a social game, so.
Yeah.
I got to tell you, I don't get a lot of apologies like that. I don't get a lot of people recognizing just how harmful those little moments add up to be. And so Jack's apology to me kind of, like, made up for a lot of times when I've had to feel so insignificant and let it roll off my shoulders for my own social mobility. So that apology, man, I'll remember that for the rest of my life.